Mum's in a good mood. God help us.
I came over all dizzy.
How high was the ladder?
Just a step ladder. That's where I hurt.
Right, sorry. Can you wiggle your toes?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna move your foot. Okay?
Yeah.
Right, well, I know it looks bad, but it is just a sprain.
That's what I thought. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. I'll strap it up for you.
It's probably nothing, but I've had a bit of a bad stomach. I've been feeling quite sick, actually.
Since you fell?
The last couple of weeks, I think.
Right, well, we'd better get it. Take a few tests just to be on the safe side. When was your last period?
Oh, no, I know what you're thinking, but I can't be. At least my husband and I have been trying for years.
Well, we'll soon see you, won't we?
Come on, it's time for breakfast. Hey?
Right.
Perhaps Daddy can do a better job, eh? Are you okay, Robert?
I'm fine. I'm off.
Have a cuddle from Harry before you go.
No, really, I've got to go. You've got my number at work in case...
I've got it all written down. I hope it's not too bad.
Thanks. Bye, Harry.
Say bye-bye to Daddy.
Robert back?
Not yet.
You look different today. Very come hither.
It's amazing what a bit of makeup and a trowel will do.
Summer smells nice.
Don't they?
Is this a wind-up?
It's Christine. She's emitting very strong pheromones today.
That's enough. Thank you, Terry.
Is Robert in yet?
Not yet. In fact, I've got to clear out of his office before he gets here.
Oh, shame. It suited you, being our leader.
Dr. Water springs to mind.
Yeah, well, I'm glad he's coming back. And I think we'd better keep an eye out for him today, OK?
Yeah, absolutely.
Chris, he is OK to come back, isn't he?
I don't know, Kath. I hope so.
He's not going to want a fuss.
No.
Well, Mrs. Lambert, you were wrong. I'm extremely pleased to tell you that you're pregnant.
Oh, my God.
The urine sample tested positive, and you are definitely pregnant.
How did you know?
Well, just a hunch, really. We have to develop a bit of a sixth sense sometimes. What I need to do now is make an appointment with your GP, and he'll arrange for you to get some antenatal care. And ice the foot and keep it up.
Are you quite sure?
Yeah.
I'll have to phone Carol.
Outside, please.
Yes, of course, I'm sorry.
Excuse me, you okay?
Yeah, sorry, I'm fine. I've just had a shock.
Oh.
No, a nice shock. I'm expecting a baby.
Well, congratulations.
You see, I thought I could never have. Sorry, this is ridiculous. I am happy, but when you're so used to... I just haven't got the hang of it yet.
They turn your life upside down, baby. Well done.
Did you not feel happy using a bank, Mr. Riley?
Banks are no longer to be trusted.
Yes, but unfortunately, neither is stomach acid. Tends to weed away your savings.
£163.
No joking.
I'm telling you, look. There's notes there.
All right, Terry, 163. Any more for any more?
84. I'm going to get to keep it.
Oh, you'd want to after it had been deposited, so to speak.
It'll wash down, be good as new, won't it?
You must be broke.
Okay, put me down for 74.
74?
82.
What do I win? Well, I see chaos has descended in my absence.
No worries, Robert, we can't do without you.
What are you doing?
Fine.
Yeah.
You're tired.
Good to see you, Rob.
Thanks, Stu.
Yeah, we're all really sorry.
Where's Christine?
Oh, she's in your office. Do you want a coffee?
Nope. Absolutely fine, as you were.
St. Victor's A&E.
Yeah, what's the ETA?
Who's been sitting in my chair?
Oh, my God, you made me jump. I'm nearly done. And it'll all be yours again.
Have I missed much?
No, just the usual.
Did they all behave for you?
Well, I don't have your natural authority, but it's okay. Mike was great, really, really supportive, and Kathy and Terry and all of them. And David, well, David was David. Right, I'm finished. Look, if you just want to do paperwork today or...
No, I'm fine. Yeah. Besides, it doesn't feel right at home.
No. You look tired.
Part of the course, eh?
Christine. Robert.
Hey.
Both of you, a young man, severe asthma attack. Arrive in about 2 minutes.
Your shout or mine?
I've got it.
I have 15 milligrams TPA, 2.5 of morphine and 10 maximum.
What's the story, Terry? This is Jason.
Felt a bit wheezy at the gym this morning. He's had asthma since childhood. He's on Ventolin and Becketide.
Okay, this is the 5 milligram salbutamol nebulizer.
Oh, one I prepared earlier.
See, Jason, this comes of going to the gym. I steer clear myself.
I see that, Terry.
Oh, back at Mr. Universe.
Are you okay to do this, Robert?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Excuse me, lady.
It's all right. So how did you do this?
I was tuning my piano. It really was very flat, you see. I can't live without that music.
Well, I think you've dislocated your shoulder. Wait a minute. Martin! Just 1 minute, Mr. Simmons. I'll be back.
Not to worry.
Oh, Kathy, we've got one on walkabout.
Okay, I'll sort it.
Excuse me. I want to see Dr. Griggs.
He's with another patient, but if you want to see someone else, take a seat.
I'm not a patient. I need to see Mike.
Is he expecting you?
Not exactly. But I'm not going until I've seen him.
Right. Well, why don't you take a seat and I'll try and find him for you, but we're really busy at the moment, so you might have a bit of a wait.
I'm prepared to wait.
Who shall I say?
Tell him it's Stella.
Right.
Now then, James.
Jason.
Jason, sorry. Does it hurt anywhere when you breathe in, Jason?
Robert.
A big one. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's too big to aspirate. We'll have to put a chest drain in.
Local, please, Terry.
Yep. Right, Jason. You got a small puncture in your lung, what we call a pneumothorax. I'm going to drain the air out that's gathered there. Won't hurt.
Yes, sir.
And just pop your arm behind your head, please, Jason.
That's it. There's the first one. You should feel this going dead now, can you? Good. Good. All right, I'll be over in a sec. Here we go. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, that's okay. It.
Worst is over. That's the worst one.
Robert, you're not sterile anymore.
It's a mistake. I'm always doing it.
Okay, Robert.
Yeah. Take it easy, Jason. Have you?
You just relax, mate.
Done in a minute.
Yep.
Okay.
Put you back on this bed a bit, Jason. Yeah. Can you keep
relax,
your arm up?
Yes, just.
You do it.
Steady, steady.
I want you to do it.
Oh, Jason. You don't get to choose, you know.
Just... You want me to lend a hand?
Yeah. I don't want you to do it.
Hey, Jason, you got a top man here, all right?
I don't want him to touch me.
Just calm down, Jason.
You're right, Jason.
What do you want for your suit, Robert?
Louis' pressure's dropping.
Christine, you can look at this.
Yeah,
Steve. Yeah, Robert. Got it.
Can't hold it on.
Okay, yeah.
Robert.
What?
Shoot you.
Listen to me. Hey, listen to me.
I can't do this unless you're still. All right, pal?
I don't want this in me. Get off! Oh, no. Get away from me! I don't want you!
Okay. Jason, look at me now. Just be calm, okay?
Got him.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it, Robert. It's all right.
I can do it,
okay? We need a new dressing.
Okay.
I'll get a new dressing. Come on, quick. You okay? Put your hand on there.
I've got them.
I've got them.
I've got the cardiology registrar down here while I'm at it, shall I?
Yeah. Well done, Lou.
Come in here, Martin. You have to wait your turn like everyone else.
I need to see a doctor, telling you.
Look, here he is, the main man. He's the one I want to see, not some little shite like you. Hello, boss man. I've been hanging around this hospital for about 4 hours now.
Here, okay, Martin.
What's the matter with you? Has somebody died?
Martin, get yourself a bed in detox. Please.
I've still got a right to see a doctor. You've got to see me, even if I have just done.
St. Victor's, A&E, go ahead.
Mind if I join you? Aren't you supposed to be in school?
Dad's taking us to the dentist this after.
I'm really sorry about your wife.
Well, we weren't married, actually, Richie, but thank you. Still miss your mum?
No, not really.
Liar.
You don't remember her.
I do. She was a good cook.
What, better than your dad?
Yeah. She made great roast dinners. Roast beef and Yorkshire pudding. Dad can't do Yorkshire pudding to save his life.
So to be a great dad, you've got to master the art of Yorkshire pudding?
Yeah, definitely.
I'll bear that in mind.
Robert, have you switched your bleep off?
Yes, sorry.
There's a collapsed woman coming in. It sounds serious.
What's that, coffee for me?
Yeah.
We will.
Have you seen your dad?
No, we're waiting for him too. Jump's gone up for him?
No, No, I'll find him.
Hey, what have we got? 39-year-old pregnant woman collapsed and found at home by her husband. She's in shock. BP 70 systolic, pulse 140.
You come over here, mate.
She was only here this morning.
I saw this woman this morning and she was fine.
Well, she's clearly very far from fine now, isn't she?
Yeah, but I don't want to hear it, David.
Has anyone seen Mike?
I need you, Kathy.
On my three. 1, 2, 3. Get the on-call gynae consultant down and anaesthetist. She's got to go to the theatre.
Okay. All right, Sue. We've got you. Don't worry about it.
Gallic consultant's been paid, Robert Stewart.
Harry.
I'm going to need to check your abdomen, Sue.
Okay. All right. Okay. You're okay now. I'm going to take good care of you.
Stewart, can you get a line in on this side?
Yeah. This isn't bloody right.
Kathy?
BP 70 systolic.
He's still nearly losing the baby.
Come on. Christ, they come.
You're not going to, love. Not now we've come this far.
Excuse me.
Oh, I'm so sorry, darling.
Shit, can't somebody do something?
Try to get Sue comfortable so we can transfer her to theatre, okay?
She's losing the baby.
Judy, could you?
We need to prepare your wife for surgery, Mr. Lambert, okay? So I need you to come to the relatives' room with me where I can explain more about it.
Just hang on in there for me.
Would you like some of this?
No,
I've got to bring something just to keep
you. You have been told to leave once already today.
Well, I'm not going until I've seen a doctor.
What's wrong with you?
I've got a cough.
And go to the chemist and get some cough mixed.
I don't feel right.
You don't feel right. Have you got a ticket?
No, I haven't got a bloody ticket. I just don't feel very well. Oh, it's stupid. They're always like this with me.
Martin, number 78. When the nurse calls number 78, you trot up to her and you tell her about your cough. You tell her the nature of your cough, whether it be dry, chesty, or just a little bit tickly. At present, the current waiting time for non-emergency cases is Well, you're looking at about 4 hours. But rest assured, you will be the last person seen today. If a sick dog comes in here, I will see it before you, okay? All right. Alternatively, you know where the door is.
I'm not waiting 4 hours.
No, that's your choice.
4 hours? That's bloody ridiculous. What's going on here? Swanning around doing nothing, you little shite.
Nothing. You think we're doing nothing? Fine. Come on, then. I'll show you.
Where's that bloody gynae consultant?
There you go, Martin.
Dr. Scobie?
Hey, hey, hey. Is she dying?
Come on, Martin. Come on.
It wasn't my fault. I didn't do anything to her. No, I'm not
sorry,
helping.
Bad idea. I know.
That's it. Out.
Out!
Go out!
Stuart, bring that bloody woman up again.
Yeah.
Robert.
Hi.
Lovely to see you.
This is Sue. Positive pregnancy test this morning. Husband found her collapsed. She's in shock, pelvic tenderness, history of infertility.
Let's get you sorted out then, love, shall we? Is the test all ready?
Ready to go.
Okay.
Yeah, ready. Okay.
What is it?
I thought the world of her, Kath. I never told her.
She knew.
Did she?
They do it all the time, the dirty buggers. They want locking up.
Do you know where you are, Noreen?
Of course I'd be lucky to.
All right, you are then.
Treat me like a simpleton.
This is Noreen from Springdale Residential. Had a bit of a fall, haven't we, Noreen?
Bloody buggers pushed me, they did.
Any relatives?
Yeah, daughter, I gave her a ring. She'll be here after a shift.
That bitch. I don't want her coming near me.
Okay, Noreen, let's take a look at you.
Oh, now, don't you touch me.
I need to see where you've hurt yourself. Then I can give you some painkillers.
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Fletcher, Noreen. You've seen me before.
I never have. I always have a man.
Yeah, well, you've got me today.
You're not married.
No, not anymore.
Not surprised.
Really turning on the charm today, aren't we, Noreen?
I'm better off with a man.
Well, we'll have to sort you out with an X-ray. But I'm afraid I can tell already that you've broken your hip. You're going to need an operation. Judy, can you arrange to take the lovely Noreen up?
Of course I can. Come on then, Trouble.
Yeah, what are you doing to me?
We're going on a wee adventure.
Oh.
I'll see you later. Not that you deserve it.
I don't want you. I want a man.
Join the club.
Thanks.
Sue's gone up now. Mrs. Longton, the gynecological consultant, will be doing the operation. She's very good. She's in safe hands.
She's dying, isn't she?
She's bleeding very heavily. We need to stop the bleeding.
She was all right this morning. She can't just die.
She won't die. Do you want to sit down?
Will they be able to save the baby?
See, the baby's been growing inside the fallopian tube, and the tube's ruptured. So to stop the bleeding, we have to remove the tube with the fetus inside it.
But she only has one good tube because of the endometriosis.
I'm sure they'll be aware of that.
Oh, that's it then, isn't it?
Her fertility will be compromised, yes. The priority is to save her life.
She won't be able to cope with this.
You could still have a child, Cal.
39-year-old woman with her tubes up the spout. Don't give me that.
I'm sorry.
10 years we've been trying. She hates herself. Thinks she's failed me. And I keep saying it'll be fine. It'll all work out. What do I say to her now? You tell me.
Right, that should make you feel sleepy now, Mrs. Simmons.
Right, you are.
Splendid.
Oh, there you are.
Ah, Kathy, can you give me a hand, please?
Sure.
Just move in this for a second. Let's get this shoulder sorted out. Ready?
Yeah. The boys are waiting for you.
Yeah, I'm taking it to the dentist after this. I'll pull the resist.
Okay.
Okay? Oh, here we go.
Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Stella's in reception.
She hasn't seen the boys, has she?
What are you doing?
I've got to get the boys out of here.
What about your patient?
Just bear with me, Simmons. One more time. Okay. Lovely.
Mike, what do you want me to say to her? She's been waiting for ages.
Tell her what you like.
She is their mother.
I want my mother.
All right, Mr. Simmons. I brought her some lunch. Brie and bacon or prawn mayonnaise.
Should have come here, you know.
I think you should go home. I don't think you're ready.
There's a woman up in the theatre. I need to go and see if she's all right.
To observe, Anne, if that's okay.
Fine, Robert, have you got a mask?
Oh, yes, sir.
She's still a bit tight. Jessops, please. It looks like the other tube is shot, too. How's she doing at the top end?
Not brilliant. Look, can you get onto the blood bank and ask for another six? Oh, and try and negotiate for some platelets and FFP. Crossed over the divide, Robert?
Oh, yeah, something like that. Any chance of saving that tube, Anne?
This tube really isn't doing her any good.
I mean, they're really desperate for a child. They've been trying for 10 years.
Robert, I've done this operation hundreds of times. Stitch, please.
So, she'll be infertile?
IVF will be an option. Large abdo, please. Robert, you're not listening to me. She can't have a baby if she's dead, can she? I don't know what your motives are for behaving like this, but I am going to have to ask you to leave now. Please.
I don't want to worry you, Anne, but our precious 60 over nothing.
That's it, bring in the shop guy, didn't
I? Steady on now, man.
Get off me!
You made me look like a dying woman. I'm going to have him!
All right, you said your piece,
I'll
come on!
I'll do you, bastard!
What are you doing here? Did you upset the porter as well?
He wants locking up.
I'm going to have to move you.
Hi, I'll give you a hand.
Oh.
Where are you going?
Miners.
Right, where you stay?
Okay.
This is the doctor I want. This is the doctor I always see.
He's a paediatrician, Noreen. He's no good to you.
Oh, no. Think I could find a use for him if I were pushed.
You look different.
Oh, don't you start. Did Terry put you up to this?
No one. Not guilty. No, I've been trying to hold you a week.
She's not married, you know.
Oh, I do know.
Excuse me.
All I want to do is take her for a drink, Noreen. Or a walk, or a drink and a walk.
Well, she can't afford to be choosy.
That's enough out of you for one day.
Is that a no, then?
Hi, Mandy.
Hi.
Oh, let's get you seen, too. Shall I call Stuart?
Yeah, please. Oh.
Hi, can you put a call out for Stuart Phelan, please? She pulled through.
I'll tell the husband.
No, I won't tell the husband. This woman is my patient now. Robert, I hope you know that what you did in there was bloody stupid.
What's up?
Bride.
It's a mess.
Hi, Stuart.
Why are you here?
Well, I was just passing and some of the guests ran out and held us down, so I thought it'd be quicker than calling an ambulance.
Mandy's been ever so good. She's gone out of her way. I said City General would be closer, but she said I'd be better off here.
Right, well, thanks, Mandy. We'll take over now, eh?
No, it's all right. I said I'd take her back to the reception when you've finished.
Right, let's pop you in this chair. You must be tired out from walking up and down that aisle all day.
Oh, thanks. Oh, shit, it bloody hurts. Oh, this is nice.
Robert.
Oh, shit. David, don't creep up on me like that.
Sorry. Robert, I just wanted to say about Martin. I didn't mean to disrupt recess, but, you know, he wound me up and I'm sorry I missed the ectopic. But she wasn't complaining of any pain. I mean, she didn't even know she was pregnant.
An ectopic pregnancy can present without pain.
Yeah, I know.
But her history, you should have done a scan, kept her under observation.
She's not.
No, she's not.
God for that. For a minute there, I thought you were going to say that, you know, she'd...
David, I don't think this is going to work out.
What?
I don't think you're suited to A&E.
You're joking.
You don't treat your patients like people. You're not a good team player. And today, you seriously failed a patient. I think you should think about resigning.
What?
And if you don't, then I shall have to think about it for you.
I help you? I'm looking for Mike Gregson. I've been sat out there all day waiting. I've been very patient. I've been reasonable.
It's okay, Terry. I'll deal with this.
Where is he? Can I see him now?
I'm sorry, Mike's just left.
What? Did you tell him I was here?
I did, yeah.
He's not going to do this to me.
Stella.
I just want to see my children.
Have you take your coffee?
Black, no sugar.
Thanks.
You're a good friend of Mike's?
Something like that.
He's told you all about me?
Some.
All bad, I've no doubt. There are two sides to every story, Kathy.
I think Mike just doesn't want his kids to get hurt again.
Do you think I want that? Can I show you something? This is Paul, a week after he was born. And this is him with his little brother, Richie. He told me that day that he'd rather have a pet hamster.
But they look really different now. They're almost young men. And you know, Mike's done a fantastic job on them. They're bright and funny and sweet.
Look, Cathy, all I want to tell them is that I haven't stopped thinking about them.
And then what? Just going to leave them again when they're at their most vulnerable. Look, this has nothing to do with me. This is between you and Mike.
But Mike won't talk to me.
Well, I'm sorry, but I don't know what I can do about that.
Do you want to know how I got them? It was Mike told you about his naughty wife who cut herself with razor blades. I like them in a funny sort of way. They remind me of how much I've achieved. You know, I used to think I was nothing. I had two beautiful boys and a brilliant husband, but I was in a blur. So I caught myself. And while I... One afternoon, my little five-year-old son said he'd make me a cup of tea because he thought it would make me feel better. And Mike came home to find Paul about to pour boiling hot water down himself. He said I was an unfit mother, which I was. But I've worked hard on myself these past 7 years, so I can feel deserving again. Until I see my boys again, I'm stuck. The thought of holding them makes me want to burst. I am their mother, Kathy. I'm their mother.
I told Mark to stay at the reception. One of us had to be there.
Was you at least having a good time before this happened?
Oh, yeah. I can thoroughly recommend it. Are you married?
No. We've escaped so far.
Don't say that. Mark didn't want to get married either. I had to practically force him.
Okay, small sting.
Have you got a girlfriend?
No. Young, free and single.
I bet you've got him queuing up.
I bet he has.
What about you?
Sad and single, I'm afraid. Waiting for someone tall and handsome to sweep me off my feet.
Oh.
Get these stitches in you, eh?
Why don't you ask her out, Stuart?
I think you've been on the champagne, haven't you?
No, I think you make a great couple. And it'd be because of me that you come together. Oh, go on, Stuart.
I don't think so, eh?
I'm sorry. Comes of being married, you want everyone to pair off.
Well, you know, we could go out for a drink sometime. I'd like that.
The thing is, Amanda, I don't want you to take this the wrong way. It's not personal. I'm just not into dating coppers.
Oh, right.
Don't be mental. She's all right.
Sorry.
I've just remembered, I've got to...
Wait a minute.
Yeah, come in. Would you like a cup of tea? I've just discovered the joys of mango and ginseng.
Oh, no thanks, I'll pass.
prefer to stay off the hard stuff for the time being. I'm really sorry, Anne.
I never had children myself. Nothing wrong. I was just too busy, striving, career. But I distinctly remember, not that long ago, it suddenly hitting me. A sense of loss is a terrible thing.
Yes.
And the irony, of course, about doctors is that we're very bad at healing ourselves. But that is when we put our patients' lives at stake.
I'll be fine, Anne, really.
Not on today's showing, you went. What are you playing at, Robert?
I just wanted to help him.
Oh, I can assure you, you did her no favours whatsoever. You know the rules, Robert. You never, and I mean never, interrupt another surgeon. Especially at such a critical stage.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. I just wasn't thinking straight.
Well, you shouldn't have come back to work until you could think straight.
I think you'll enjoy this too.
Oh, babe! Oh, sorry, I missed it. Oh.
No, you haven't.
What do you mean?
I brought the mountain to Mohammed.
You don't mind, do you, the fellas?
No, no.
Oh, no. So, no.
She's gonna have to do it here.
Hey.
Hi.
How was the dentist?
Great. They've got great teeth, just like their dad.
Mike, We need to talk about Stella.
Is she gone? Good. End of subject.
Mike, you can't keep this up, you know. She's not going to stay away forever.
Did I say I was interested in this?
Look, she has rights, you know, whether you like it or not.
No, she gave up her rights when she walked out on us. Does this make you feel good, Kathy?
What?
Doling out compassion like this, does it make you feel involved?
I am involved.
Why do you want to go talking to her behind my back anyway? Whose side are you on?
I'm not on anyone's side. I was just trying to be practical, that's all. Mike?
Just here.
Oh, will you hold these for me, please?
Ladies and gentlemen, a little room for the bride and groom. Yes! Isn't that lovely? That means it's you next, Chris, doesn't it?
Oh, no, 150. Shame Mandy's not here. Get swept off her feet. Mike!
I like her.
St. Victor's, A&E, go ahead. Okay. Major RTA, two adults, one serious, 3 minutes away.
What have we got?
This is Trevor. A young lad ran into the side of him at 50 miles an hour. Pulse 100, BP 120 over 90.
Okay. What?
I thought you...
You thought wrong.
What have you got, Stuart?
Definite broken collar, swollen right thigh, foot externally rotated.
Get an emergency stop there, Matt.
He's pulled out in front of me. We're in the kitchen.
We're going to want x-ray in here fast.
On
my count.
On Robert's count.
One, two, three.
Thank you.
Pulse 100, sat 94.
Now, please.
Everybody cover.
Yeah.
Quick as you can.
ECG, somebody, please.
Capillary refill's good.
Reduced air entry. Let's get a chest drain on the left. Crown vent block.
I've got the bloods, Robert.
Does it hurt here, Trevor?
BP's 120. Nice. BP 140 over 90, sat at 96.
Okay, I'll get some fluids in
him. The pain worse when I do that.
It's all over, I can't take it.
All right, we'll get you some painkillers in a minute.
Need a hand here, Stuart.
No, you're all right, Robert. I'm just waiting for his pelvic x-rays. Could be an acetabular fracture. I'll get all the figures to come.
Yeah, well, let's go get one as soon as possible.
Blood pressure's dropped. Neck veins are distended. I think I've got a temporal.
It's pulseless, EMD.
CPR, let's get him intubated. It's okay, Robert. I'm in control. Adrenaline, 1 milligram IV. We'll have to drain it. One.
Give me a cardiac needle.
Are you sure?
One. All day I've had this. I know what I'm doing. Please.
Okay. One, two. Robert.
Thank you,
Robert.
Judy. No.
Robert. Sit. Robert, that's the wrong side.
Christine, stop him.
No. Got a pulse.
Take another look at the x-ray. Okay, everybody, let's get him upstairs. Come on. Come on.
Reaction. Yeah,
that's hey, yeah. Come here. Is there anything wrong with that x-ray, Dave?
No.
No?
Heart's on the right, not the left. Extracardia. We both missed it. Robert Herver saved the day.
See, that's the giveaway. Wrong way. Right way.
Right. My shit doctor.
Hey, what are you on about?
Am I crap with patients?
Yeah, but your heart's in the right place. Dextrocardia. I wouldn't have spotted it.
Yes, you would.
Well. I'm sorry I wasn't very supportive today. I was worried.
I just want to get back to normal.
I know. We missed you. I missed you.
Good night, Chris.
Robert!
Yeah?
I'm not doing very much tonight. I could come round. I'd love to see Harry again. I could cook us something or heat something up.
No, thanks for the offer. I've got some things I need to do, actually.
Okay. Fine. See you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Oh, Gabby!
Oh, sorry.
What are you doing still here?
I couldn't leave. The stakes are very high for me, you know.
Yeah, well, pretty high for me, too.
Did you speak to him?
You put me in a really difficult position.
He still wouldn't listen, would he? He's made a good choice in you. I hope he appreciates it.
Yeah. Well, good luck, Estella.
It's not luck I need anymore, Kathy. It's a solicitor.
Anything for me, Judy?
Nope.
Nothing?
No, sorry, it's dead. Christine, patient in four, especially for you. Can't anyone else do it?
Yeah. Hello, I can do it, Judy. Me doctor.
No, this one's for Christine. What is it? Man with rash. How thrilling. Oh, which is a very thrilling rash indeed.
So, I'm not even allowed to do a rash now, am I? Don't believe this.
I thought I'd push my luck. If I'm your patient, then you have to talk to me.
Yes. But if you're my patient, I can't go out with you. Unethical.
Did it do unethical?
No.
Well, there you are. I see we have something in common. And the good news is, I haven't really got a rash.
Well. That lets us off the hook then, doesn't it?
I fixed his milk and put some washing on. I was going to make you some dinner, but I didn't get time. Sorry.
It's okay.
Oh, I forgot to ask. How was your first day back?
Oh, it was great. It's good to be back home, though.
See you tomorrow, then.
Yeah, thanks, Lynn. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Shouldn't you be asleep? We miss Mummy, don't we? Yes, we do. Come on, son. You and me got a big night's entertainment ahead of us. Batter with ribbon consistency. Have you got any idea what that means? Yeah, well, I think that'll do, don't you?
This is going to be delicious, Harry.
This is Kate Brady, the new SHO.
Hi. Well, that's at the same time, 9 o'clock next Thursday. Next tonight, we've a revealing insight into the lives of Britain's richest people.